Oh, right. This one isn't very hard once you know where to look, but I actually had to Google to get some more information because I couldn't find it. And again, Laureen probably could have done this one and done it much faster and better than I did because she's much better at CPT than I am. But the question was, you know, is there a thyroid profile or is it billed separately? And actually, one of the great places, as I pull the screen over, Quest Diagnostic is a company that does a lot of lab work, and they had really good information. That's where I got this. So first, let's break it down. There is a CPT code, Quest Diagnostic 4A, and I changed this, is a thyroid panel, not a profile. So that will give you some troubles if your verbiage is off just a little bit. So they were telling me for a thyroid panel, these are the two codes that they use, 84436 and then 84479, all right? And those include, and it goes in to detail what tests are included in that. So they, I went in and found the explanation for 84436, which gives you all of these, it tells you what it does and what it doesn't do for that particular code. And it tells you why this test is performed. Neonates get this test, which I thought was very, very interesting. Then 84479 being explained. Again, this has your T3 and T4s. This is the reason they use these abbreviations is because nobody can really actually in real life pronounce this term. And so they abbreviate that stuff. And you know T thyroid, you know, it's not as bad as you think. So that wasn't the most common. I remember seeing thyroid panels, and they usually have this TSA with them. That's always with TSA. So I thought, well, there's a specific code for that that Quest Diagnostic had. And so I thought, oh, I remember seeing that. And that is the other two panels with this additional test run, a thyroid stimulating hormone, or TSH, which is a TSA, and so you get all of those other two plus this thyroid stimulating, and it tells why they do this in this description right here, that if, you know, patients with symptoms of weight gain, tiredness, dry skin and stuff, they'll do this to see what is the problem. One of them has to do with an endocrine, the pituitary is messed up, and the other ones have to do with the thyroid itself, I believe. So to determine actually what the problem is, if they know there's possibly a problem with the thyroid, they break it up and do all of those tests. And they build the top two codes together. So there's, in my impression of what that's saying is that if you have those, if you're going to do a thyroid profile, you use those first two codes. If you're going to do a thyroid profile with a TSA, then you, or TSH, then you do, you add, there's three codes together, not one code that encompasses all of them. And they're all in that same section. If you can't find it, you can't do it for the test, go Google it, thyroid profile, and boom, 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 it's amazing all the stuff that came up.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.